Do you want to know how to get a mod menu within GTA 5 Online without a modded console? If so, you came to the right place. Stay tuned and I hope you guys do enjoy. Yo, what's going on guys? It's your boy Tropics here and welcome back to the channel. Hope you guys are all having a great day. So in today's video, like I said before, I'm showing you how to get a mod menu within GTA 5 Online without even having a modded console. So this is a very awesome thing that we have able to get within GTA 5. So sadly, this only does work with PS3. So sorry to everyone else who does not own a PS3, but basically I'm guessing a lot of you guys don't even own one, so it's kind of pointless. But this is really good for making accounts and just having fun and trolling people and just basically modding within GTA 5. And a lot of you guys have been asking for this type of video, so that's why I decided to make it for you guys. But instead of me actually making this video, I have a friend named Antihero Live who will be taking this over and actually showing you guys exactly what to do. So if you want to go check out his channel, I'll leave the links down in the description down below. So I hope this does work for most of you guys. If you have any questions, go ahead and comment down below and I'll make sure to respond to you guys ASAP. And if you're not on PS3 and you're still looking for some money or stuff like that, go ahead and check out some other videos that I have made. I have posted a bunch of different money glitches, so if that's what you're looking for, go check out my channel. But anyway, I hope you guys do enjoy. I will see you in the next video. Bless up.
So first, you're going to want to know what copy of GTA you have. So there's two copies, right? There's a Bless and a Bless. So I'm showing you guys right there on the bottom of the box right there that you can see that I have a Bless copy, right? So you need to know this so when you go to Deadit's website that there's two options. There's a Bless and a Bless option that you need to download. So here we go. I am at Deadit's website, and big shout out to Deadit too. This guy, he needs like a lot more credit than he gets, like, but yeah, and he doesn't get the credit, but that's okay. So here we go. I'm at his website, and see, here's the two copies of the Bless and the Bless. So I'm gonna download the Bless copy. That's actually Bless right there. The Bless is on the right hand side. So I'm gonna download the Bless copy, and it's really easy. I mean, you may need WinRAR, you may not. If you don't know what WinRAR is, it's a free program. It basically, it like unzips folders or something like that. But I will leave a link to WinRAR too in the description if you guys need it. So I didn't really need WinRAR when I downloaded this. It was like, it was kind of like a weird file that it gave me. But I'm just showing you guys, I'm downloading the file through my browser right now through Google Chrome. And it's pretty simple. Like, all you need is a USB stick and a PC, and you guys can mod yourself. So here we go. I'm actually downloading this to my desktop. We're gonna flip over to the desktop. I do apologize for the camera that I use. I don't have like a desktop, like a screen record. So right there, I clicked on that file, and it gave me an option to extract it. So I'm just saying yes to all because I already had this on my desktop. So I'm just hitting yes to all. And now I'm extracting that file, because that file is kind of weird. You have to extract it. And this will take, you know, it'll take like a minute or two. But once that is extracted, I'm going to show you guys what to do next. So this would be the part where you want to have your USB stick ready. And you want to have it formatted to like the 32 FAT. Or whatever it's called, and I'm gonna show you guys how to do that. I actually had like a bunch of saved stuff on my USB, so I reformatted it just to get rid of all that excess stuff, as you guys are gonna see right here. I know my desktop is like really crazy. I gotta clean that up, but there we go. So that folder right there that I just showed, that was the extracted folder. So now I'm going to my USB stick, and I'm reformatting it so I can clear everything out. What I'm doing right there. So now my USB stick is completely empty. So now I'm going to take that folder that I zoomed in on, and I'm going to click on it, and I'm going to go to the part that just says PS3. I actually clicked on the wrong one there. There we go. And I'm clicking on the extracted folder. I'm going to go to the PS3 folder, and I'm just going to grab that, and I'm going to take it into the USB, into my USB option. And this could take like a minute or two too. Like, for some reason my computer was just like lagging really bad. So once you have the USB file, you just have to go to your PS3, plug in the USB stick to the right slot on the deal. You're gonna go into your settings. You're gonna go you're gonna go into the system settings, and then you're gonna go to the backup, and then you're gonna click on restore and hit yes, and then select your USB device and hit yes there, and then you're gonna select X on that, and then here you're gonna hit okay again, and then yes again. And now this is gonna put you through like a reformatting cycle. This will take some time. If you don't want to lose your GTA game save, you might want to back that up, because this basically wipes like everything off. This wipes everything off the PS3 and just like restarts it from over, or resets all your saves. So here we go. We're gonna go through a cycle. Basically, my PS3 is like just kind of rebooting right now. You're gonna hit the PS button, like it's prompting you to do. And then from here, it's gonna go through this restoring cycle. This will take a little bit of time, and I'm just gonna kind of skip through this and get to the next process. So once you get done restoring this, once that's done, you're gonna be prompted back like onto the restart screen. You're gonna hit OK on the system storage data will be rebuilt. Hit OK on that. And then the PS3 will kind of like do like a restart cycle, sort of. Know if you did everything right if you see this stuff. So these like modded comment and those other ones, like those actually have like the menus on them, I think that's how it works. But if you see this, then you know you're good and you are on the home stretch to having your own mod menu on a PS3. So the only downside to this is that you can't play with the public. You can only play with people that have this menu, but there are a lot of people that do this. So you can go online into an open lobby and you'll probably find other modders, and it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool to do that, to play with other modders. Like, you guys can have modded fights, you can do whatever you want. The other tip is too, if you do want to play with your friends regularly, you can buy GTA on the PSN store. So if you load in that PSN store GTA, that will actually let you play with your friends. So this is how you know if you've done everything totally right. You will see like this weird GTA loading screen. Dead Edits did this himself. This is like his customized loading screen. Like I said, big shout out to Dead Edits. Like, this guy's a straight boss. He's a coding genius. And he's really cool too. He actually hooked up my friend with some dev files so he can make us mod menus. So big shout out to Dead Edits. Go check him out. I'll probably link his Twitter, his YouTube channel. I'll link all that stuff. Go check him out. Show him some love and tell him thank you for this awesome, awesome, awesome mod menu. He's a straight boss. So basically, to open up this menu, and once you go to play GTA, you're gonna have to re-download it and everything, or reinstall it. But to open up this menu, it's just L1 and L3, and that's boom, and that's it. I'm gonna do some more modded tutorials on how to use this stuff in the next coming up videos. Like, I got a ton of videos that I could do with all this USB modding stuff. I'm gonna have all that stuff on my channel, so get ready to learn how to mod without a jailbreak, because that's where this channel is going to be heading for just a little bit, and then I will do whatever stuff that's next. All right guys, enjoyed this video. If you're new to my channel, hell yeah, subscribe. I'm Anti-Hero Live, and get your mod menus online, boy. Peace.